Greetings, everybody. Irish Trekkie back with another Nerd Escape podcast. And with me, as always, we have the amazing Chris the Trek Collector. How are you today, my good man?
Absolutely fantastic. And oh, do we have a little interview for all you little ship geeks and people that love the designs and the schematics and the internals of everything Star Trek.
And before, if you get a little taste of the genius that is Rick in this interview, we did get to interview Rick for the Nerd Escape many moons ago, so check out the Nerd Escape playlist after that, where it's about an hour long. But yeah, I hope you enjoy this interview. So next face you're going to see is R2 and Rick, so enjoy. Hi folks, welcome to a very special in the field Nerd Escape interview with the awesome Rick Sternbach. Finally in the flesh, we got him over here. Yay!
Oh, thank you guys.
You're very welcome.
Yeah, it's great to be here. Yeah.
Oh, delighted to have you. So we're going to pick Rick's brain ever so gently. So we're going to pass you over to my awesome colleague Chris.
Because you worked on so much, was setting up shows. So like you were there on the movies, and then the Next Generation got announced. You also worked with Deep Space Nine and Voyager. How did you find the journey setting up these shows for us?
Well, I was really, you know, one cog in a massive machine. But we all, you know, we all pretty much knew our jobs. You know, I got to know the studio setup on the first motion picture. Okay, you know, where the construction mill was, where the blueprint building was. You know, getting to know all of the individual parts of this operation, and it came in very handy on Next Generation, where we developed you know, a whole sequence of things that had to be designed and fabricated, or you know, with the set designers, they would have to do their blueprints. We did sketches before the blueprints were made, you know, to kind of give the producers some idea of okay, what is this set going to look like? Okay, my favorite way of doing that was really to build models for the producers, for the writers, a model, you know, a physical scale model of, you know, even if it's rough foam core, a physical model, they could stand around it and they could talk. Rick Colby, who was one of our wonderful directors, he loved the models that we built because he could say, all right, I want to bring the camera in through this window here, or I want to be able to wild this wall out and you know, and follow these actors and things like that. So I knew right then, okay, that a physical model made from either sketches or the set designers' elevation drawings, okay, could really shorten the process, could really streamline things. And they loved those models. I mean, you know, we did models of the set for the Inner Light, okay, where you had, you know, you had two-story kind of structures and little stairways and lots of windows and doors and things like that. So we built what we could, and in some cases the construction people would get involved and look at the model and say, you know, listen, we may be going over budget if we build the second floor. Okay. Well, it's better to find out early, you know, than run over budget and kill the whole schedule. So the set designers would make adjustments. We might adjust the models, do another couple of sketches, and really kind of bing, 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 get this whole process, you know, finished up for each episode. Yeah.
Awesome. And just while we have you here, I just wanted to give you something on behalf of the Nerd Escape. So this is just a little token from the Nerd Escape to show our appreciation, because you've played such a fundamental and prolific part. And you are right, it does take a village to build a show like this. But, you know, you're a proud member of that village. And we have a ship in a bottle
for you. Oh, great. Oh, excellent.
So something small. Look at
that, with warp stars and everything.
Warp stars and everything.
Did you see that? Get the glare off of that? Wow. How cool. Thank you.
So just a little, thank you. That's excellent. Something.
That's excellent. Wonderful. And yes, you got the right reg number. And very cool. Very cool. Oh, can I tell you a funny story?
Sure.
When we built the 3-foot mock-up, okay, I put just some random registration number. You know, USS Voyager, NCC, and it was something totally different.
Yeah.
And Rick Berman looks at this mock-up, and he sees the little placard, and he says, "Who authorized that number?"
Calm down.
You know, it's just a placeholder. It's just, you know, it's just something to fill in until we actually get the number. You know, he was okay about it. He was all right. But, you know, man, I've started sweat bullets. You know, who said that's going to be the number?
Calm down,
that's right.
Calm
that's
down.
Right. No, I learned after a while, you know, that sometime he was joking. He was just trying to, you know, trying to get us a little bit. No, good guy to work for. You know, he understood the whole you know, studio process.
I suppose with the demanding work schedule, to have those little icebreakers and tension reliefs every so often helped a lot.
Oh yeah, oh yeah.
Kippers and coffee, though, I'd say wouldn't be the best. Nah. Oh, you know about that story?
Well, astronaut Walter Schirra, Wally Schirra, who was on Mercury and Apollo, he said levity is appropriate in a dangerous trade.
Yes, yes.
So, we kind of blew off steam once in a while.
Yeah.
Yeah, had fun.
Has to be done.
Yeah, yeah. You know, you have to have fun with it. You know, Star Trek is, you know, it's a wonderful entertainment product. And you can't get super serious about it all the time, you know?
Yes.
So.
That's good. That's good.
Thanks a million, Rick. So, we'll wrap up there. We'll let the other lads have their show.
Thank you very much for your time.
Thank you.
Now, that was such a fun interview, and actually getting to meet Rick face to face was brilliant. I probably had a hand nearly fall off him. Well, I was nice enough to do things in little bits and batches, but like, he's been involved in the next gen tech manual, the Deep Space Nine tech manual. He's been involved in so much stuff, and as you know what I mean, throughout the years of Star Trek, he's been involved. And like Damien did say before this interview, that we did do a podcast back in our early days, and it was around an era. But anyone that is a fan of kind of like schematics, ship design, layout, it's, you know, it is worth listening to.
I was just going to say, I'm sure it came through in the interview, and even in the first interview as well. But we got to hang out with him after the con over the weekend as well a few times. And man, that guy is just a ball of energy and just cracked me up every single time I was talking to him. So if you get a chance to, all you folks over in the States, if he's at a convention, go check him out. Say the Nerd Escape said hi, and it'll definitely be worth the travel, because he would give you so much time. And I hope you enjoyed those interviews.
Like last year with Johnny was just amazing. And this year with Ryan Denning and Rick, I would like to say big shout out to everybody at Eagle Moss, and big shout out to Ben Robinson for making it so.
Making it
and we
so.
We hope to see
Segway.
Very more. At the next DST.
So this is one off a few interviews that we did at DST. So do check out the description box below for the Nerdscape playlist, where you will see interviews with JG, with Chase, with Tracy, and our DST shenanigans roundup as well. So thanks for taking the time out of your day to stop by and check us out. And as always, it's goodbye from me.
Slán go fóill, íomhá, and goodbye from me. Live long and prosper.